Good morning, dear students. Today I shall start the short story "The Fight" by Perry Thomas. Before starting this story, I want to tell you in a nutshell, in short, the outline of this story, means the story in brief. This short story, "The Fight" by Perry Thomas, is about two boys, two friends, who have grown up together and are such great friends that they feel like brothers. Set in New York City, but heavily influenced by Puerto Rican culture, the story describes two boys' love of boxing. For both, boxing has been a way to escape the negative influences that frequently beset young men in the inner city. When the two boys, Antonio and Felix, learn that they are to compete against each other in the biggest fights of their lives, they are conflicted. They are such good friends and they don't want to hurt each other. They decide to fight each other. They decide to fight each other without pulling and punching, and it does not destroy their friendship. Despite beating each other quite severely in the match, they walk away from the fight arm in arm as the great friends they always were. This is the main theme of the story. Now we shall start reading the text and I shall explain the necessary and complicated words also. The Fight by Perry Thomas. 17 years old Antonio Cruz and Felix Burgos are childhood friends and aspiring lightweight champions. Aspiring means wanting or dreaming to be something. Lightweight champions means boxing champions in the lightweight category, a category of boxers of a certain weight. Each has fought many boxing matches and won few medals. Recently, they have been informed that they will fight each other in the division finals 2 weeks away. The winner will represent the boys' club in the Golden Globes championship tournament. One morning, less than a week before their match, the match was already decided between both the friends that in a lightweight championship, both the friends will be the competitor, they will fight each other there. Less than a week before their match, Antonio and Felix met as usual for their daily workout. They ran lightly along the river's edge. Along the river's edge, they were running lightly and they were doing their practice as they were doing in the past. Antonio glanced at Felix. Antonio saw Felix, who kept his eyes purposely straight ahead, who was keeping his eyes straight while he was running. after a mile or so, Felix said, let's stop a while. Means let us stop our practice for a short while. Brother, I think we both got something to say to each other. I think that both of us something in our heart, and I think it necessary that we should share our feelings, stopping our practice here. Antonio nodded and accepted that yes, whatever you say is correct. Both of us has something to share to each other. I was not natural to be acting as though nothing unusual was happening when two best friends were going to be blasting. Blasting means striking hard each other within a few days. It was not natural to be acting as though nothing unusual was happening when two boys, two best friends were going to be blasting, means striking hard each other within a few days. Felix learned on the reverse railing and started crossing to the source of Brooklyn. Antonio helped. It is about our fight, right? Means the things which we have in our heart is about our fight. And you want to share your feelings related to the fight which will happen after a week. Yes, right. I have been thinking about it too. I was also thinking about it too. In fact, since we found out it was going to be me and you, I have been awake at night pulling punches means hitting less forcefully than he can on you, trying not to hurt you. Means while I was punching, my purpose was not to hurt you. Same here. Isn't natural not to think about the fight? I mean, we both are fighters and we both want to win. One of his friends says, Felix said, that both of us are fighters and both of us want to win. But only one of us can win. But when the fight will go on, only one will win. There are no draws in the eliminations. So we will not eliminate ourselves from that fight because it is already decided. Felix tapped Antonio gently on the shoulder. Felix put his hand on the shoulder of Antonio and tapped it. Tommy, let's promise something right here. You promised here something that the same thing we will do when we will be in the boxing ring. If it is fair, hermano, I am fine. Hermano, I Spanish word for friend. It is fair, Tommy. When we get into the ring, it is a gotta be like we never met. Means when we will go into the ring, we will behave like two strangers. We gotta be like two strangers that want the same thing and only one can have it. You understand? Okay, don't see Spanish word for yes. I know. Tommy smiled. No pulling punches. There we should not punch each other. We go all the way and we should fight there in the ring in a natural way. That's right. Listen, Tommy, don't you think it is a good idea if we don't see each other until the day of the fight? Tommy scratched his nose thoughtfully. He started scratching his nose thoughtfully, whatever the word his friend said to him. After hearing the words, his friends said to him, "Yes, it would be better for our heads. It would be better for our heads." He held out his hand, palm upward. He held out his hand and palm upward and said that this is the deal between both of us. That we will go there in the ring. Okay, outside of the ring, we are fast friends. But there, we will behave like a stranger. Deal. Felix highly slapped. Open skin. Let's cut it here. After the fight, we can get it together again like nothing ever happened. Felix lightly slapped open skin. Let's cut it here. After the fight, we can get it together again like nothing ever happened. The amigo brothers hugged each other tightly. Both the friends. The original title of this story is Amigo Brothers. But here in your book, the title is given the fight. The Amigo Brothers hugged each other tightly. Both hugged each other tightly. Both friends hugged tightly. The days in training passed much too slowly. The days in training passed much too slowly. Slowly and slowly, the days were passing. Although they kept out of each other's way, they were aware of each other's progress. While the ghetto grapevine, ghetto an overcrowded part of a city where people belonging to a particular community or group live in poor conditions. Grapevine, a network or system of rumors and unofficial information. Large posters plastered all over the walls of local shops announced the fight between Antonio Cruz and Felix Vargas as the main match. Large posters plastered all over the walls of the local walls of the cities, and it was announced that on such a day there will be a fight of lightweight championship. In that boxing championship, both the fast friends Antonio and Felix will be in the ring. The fight had created great interest in the neighborhood. Antonio and Felix were well linked and respected. People respected Antonio and Felix both in the neighborhood, in the locality, in the city. Each had his own loyal following. Most of the people in the city were following him. They were fans of Antonio and Felix. The fight was scheduled to take place in Tomiskin Square Park. Gymnasium of the boys club was not large enough to hold all the people who were sure to. Attend. In Tomiskin Square Park, everyone who wanted could view the fight. Those who wanted, they can view the fight. Such facility was provided there. Whether from ringside or window, fire escapes or rooftops. Some were seeing the fight on sitting on the rooftops. The local junior high school across from Tomiskins Square Park served as the dressing room for all the fighters. All the fighters were dressing themselves there. The place was allotted to them. The loudspeakers blared into the open windows of the school. The loudspeakers were blaring and the announcements were continuously made on the loudspeakers that were kept in the near the open windows of the school. There were speeches by dignitaries. Dignitaries were giving their speeches. Communities, leaders and great boxers of yesterday's. This great day was in the tradition of champions emerging from the streets of the Lower East Side. Lower East Side, a working class neighborhood in New York City, where people from different countries came and settled down, often living in difficult conditions. Felix was accompanied from the classroom by a dozen fans in white t-shirts with the word Felix across their fronts. Antonio was also girded down a different stairwell and guided through a roped off path. As the two friends climbed in the ring, the crowd exploded with a roar. The crowd started cheering them loudly. The fans of Antonio's were cheering Antonio on one side, and the fans of Felix were also encouraging Felix on the other side. Antonio and Felix bowed gracefully. When they entered the ring, both the friends bowed the spectators respectfully, raised their arms in acknowledgement, and raised their arms that they accepted their cheering, they accepted their welcome. Bong, 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 the road turned to stillness. Ladies and gentlemen, the announcer spoke slowly. Ladies and gentlemen, in this corner, waiting 134 pounds, 1 pound equal to 400 grams, and you can multiply, the result will be before you. Waiting 134 pounds, Felix Burgess, and in this corner, waiting 133 pounds, Antonio Cruz. The winner of this match will represent Boys Club in the Tournament of Champions, the Golden Globes. There will be no draws. May the best man win. The announcer was making an announcement that on one side of the ring, Felix Burgess, a boxing athlete of 134 pounds. On the other side, Antonio, a boxer of 133 pounds. The cheering of the crowd shook the window panes of old buildings surrounding Tomiskins Square Park. At the center of the ring, the referee was giving instructions to the youngster. The referee was giving instructions to both the boxers entering into the ring. Keep your punches up, means the referee, keep one hand of both the boxers and showing to the spectators like this. Keep your punches up. No low blows, no punching on the back of head means here punching on the back of the head is not allowed. Keep your heads up. Understand? Let's have a clean fight. Means there should be no teaching, there should be no cheating, and the fight will be clear. No, now shake hands and come out fighting. Now shake both of you your hands and start fighting in a good way. Both youngster touched gloves and nodded like this. They touched the gloves and they nodded. They turned and danced quickly to their corners. They turned and danced quickly to their corners. Both the boxers went back to their corners and started dancing. Bang, bang, round one. Felix and Antonio turned and faced each other in a fighting pose like this, that they were going to start the fighting. Felix wanted no time. Felix did not want any time. He came in fast. Head low, half hunched towards his right shoulder and lashed out in a straight left. Means straight left means a kind of blow used in boxing struck by the left fist. Antonio slipped the punch, saved himself from that punch, and responded, hit back with 1, 2, 3 lefts that sent a mild shock coursing through Felix. If Felix had any doubt about their friendship affecting their fight, it was being neatly dispelled, it was being neatly removed or driven out. Antonio danced, a joy to behold. Antonio started dancing, a joy to behold. His left hand was like a piston. Piston means a part of an engine that moves up and down and makes other parts move like this. Piston. He was ready for boxing. His left hand was like a piston pumping jabs. Jabs means kick. Bang! Both fighters froze a punch well on its way, sending up a roar of approval from good sports fans. Both of them, Antonio and Felix, both froze a punch well on its way, sending up a roar of approval from good sportsmen. Felix and Antonio moved quickly to their respective corners. On one side of the ring, Felix was there. Other side of the ring, Antonio was there. Both moved quickly to their respective corners. Watch that right, Tommy. His trainer talked into his ear. You gotta get it there, fella. Felix's trainer poured water over his curly afro locks. Over his curly afro locks, the trainer was putting water to make it calm. Bang, bang, another round, second round. Signal was given by the referee. Bang, bang. Round two started. Felix was off his stool. Felix left his stool and rushed Antonio like a bull. And rushed towards Antonio like a bull. Sending a hard right to his head. Antonio heard, sent back a blurring barrage of lefts and rights. Okay. A blurring barrage of lefts and rights. Blurring means making everything look blurred or hazy because of the speed with which the blows were struck. And barrage means a series of blows was given by Felix on the right and left, by right and left of Antonio. Rights to the body, lefts to the head, neither fighter was giving an inch. In a fog, Felix heard the roaring of the crowd. The roaring of the crowd was heard by Felix, who seemed to have gone insane, mad. His heart cleared to hear the bell at the end of the round. He was glad. His trainer sat him down. In his corner, Antonio was doing what all fighters do when they hurt. Antonio was hurt, so he was receiving treatment from his trainer and other kinds of things he was doing because he was injured and hurt by Felix. They sit and smile at everyone. They were sitting on both the corners and were smiling to see each other. The referee signaled the ring doctor to check the fighters out. The doctor was invited there, and the doctor checked both of them, and after some time the doctor declared that both the boxers are fit to fight. He did so and then gave his okay. The doctor gave his okay. The cold water sponge brought clarity to both soldiers. Cold water sponge was brought clarity to both the boxers. Bong, round 3 started. The final round. Up to now, it had been tic-tac-toe pretty much even. But everyone knew there could be no draw and that this round would decide. Third round was going on and the spectators were watching the third round and they were happy that in this final round we are going to get the finalist, we are going to get the winner. Both pounded away, neither gave an inch and neither fell to the canvas. The floor of the boxing ring, which is covered with canvas, a kind of strong and rough cloth. Felix's left eye was slightly closed due to the boxing hit of Antonio. Blood poured from Antonio's nose. Blood was coming from Antonio's nose. They fought toe to toe. Both the fighting was very close. The sounds of their blows were loud in contrast to the silence of a crowd gone completely mute. Bong, bong, bong. The bell sounded over and over again. Felix and Antonio were past hearing. Their blows continued to pound on each other's like hailstones. Their blows continues to pound on each other like hailstones. Means the blows which they were giving to each other, they experienced that those blows were not blows, but those blows were coming to their mouth like the hailstones coming from the sky. Finally, the referee and the two trainers pulled the two fighters apart. Cold water was poured over them to bring them back to their senses. They looked around and then rushed towards each other. A cry of alarm surged, means rose suddenly from Tomiskin Esquire Park. Was this going to be a fight to the death? People were asking a question. Was this going to be a fight to the death? The fear soon gave way to wave of cheering as the two amigos embraced. Both the fighters embraced each other, both the friends embraced each other, no matter what the decision. They knew they would always be champions to each other. Bong, 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 ladies and gentlemen, the winner and representatives to the Golden Globes Tournament of Champions is not announced. The announcer turned to point to the winner and found himself alone. Arm in arm, the champions had already left the ring. Both the friends, Antonio and Felix, left the rings, keeping each other's hands, and left the ring. Thank you.